Good morning, Atlantis. How you doing this morning?
Good morning, Houston. We're wide awake and ready to go after that rousing music. Thank you very much.
We thought you'd like that. That's for the drill team later on this morning, particularly for Billy Mack and his PFC later.
Roger, that's what we expected.
Yeah, remember, that's 06 music there.
Roger that.
Thanks a lot. We got a good target, and you can, at your convenience, take the primary logics and drivers on, get 16 of them on, and also power up the AFDDU.
Had that penciled right in on the checklist. Thank you, sir.
Okay, we're thinking alike, just marching down the line here. No need to acknowledge, we'll be updating your orbiter and target state vector.
Okay, Star, you got some downlink.
The Atlantis, the Dallas, the Divinoste Futov.
Сейчас смотрю там так, по отражению номер первый со света. 376 выдаем.
Russian interface officer is notifying the mission control in Kaliningrad that the orbiter is outside of 50 feet, meaning the Mir crew can go back to attitude control now on the space station. Current distance is 104 feet, opening at a rate of 0.37 or 3/10 of a foot per second. Mir has now been commanded back to attitude control.
Atlantis, we have a picture of Mir.
Roger.
It lands for the DAP.
Go ahead.
We're ready for auto when you are.
Thank you. There's a lot of people swimming around out here.
I'll bet. And we know.
Well, I did block 15 Delta. Did I miss a update message on that?
It's kind of hidden, sir. It's on message 77D, the second page of 3 there.
Okay, we're looking, thanks.
Yeah, I can read it too. It says page 2-15 at a PET of 205 at the point where you disable rendezvous nav to change the attitude to target 2, body vector 1, Omicron 270. Doesn't get any better than what you're sending us right now.
Sir, do you want that ergometer, or do you want to keep looking at this for a little while?
We're going to change our minds and take this. It's irresistible.
We sort of thought you might say that.
Well, you know what my vote was going to be.
Yes, sir, that's all we asked.
Affirmative. Looks like the foot of the ergometer.
Okay, that's where the seat stem attaches, and that's where the pit pin is needed. As you can see, it's quite a long pit pin that would be required. We left them the spare pit pin out of our ergometer, but I don't think that's going to be adequate.
Copy, and that image does help us.
And just to discuss a little bit more, what you see is it's our standard ergometer, and then there are these two mounting adapters that go on the floor, and each of those has four bolts. Now, here is the far end of the seat stem. This is one where a bolt was required, and what they've done is they've attached a threaded shaft to the mirror structure, and then when it's being used, Tomas will then put the install the that end of the ergometer seat rail. You can tell we're not Cecil B. DeMille on that one. And then he has a nut that just attaches to the threaded shaft. And as it turned out, he couldn't find the nut he was using at the time, but seemed confident there was plenty of that kind of hardware on there that he'd be able to